This is InfoLive TV headline news, June 22nd. I'm Margot Dutkevich. French President Nicolas Sarkozy arrives in Israel today for a three-day state visit. After an official welcome at Ben Gurion Airport, he will accompany President Shimon Peres on a helicopter tour of the Dead Sea, Masada and En Gedi. On Sunday evening, he will dine with Prime Minister Ehud Olmert and on Monday is scheduled to meet the parents of Gilad Shalit. The High Court of Justice is due this morning to hear a petition filed by the parents of kidnapped soldier Gilad Shalit against the government's decision to lift the economic blockade and open the border crossings between the Gaza Strip and Israel before their son is released from captivity. The petitioners maintain that Noam Shalit met with Prime Minister Olmert six times and was assured there'd be no ceasefire with Hamas until his son's release. Iran criticized Saturday a recent Israeli military exercise that U.S. officials said was designed to show Jerusalem's ability to attack Tehran's nuclear sites. Iran's official news agency quoted a government spokesman as saying that the exercises prove Israel jeopardizes global peace and security. The New York Times published details of the exercise on Friday. Jordan's King Abdullah II told the Washington Post that he was dissatisfied with U.S. President George W. Bush's most recent visit to the region. In an exclusive interview, he said he'd become more concerned after Bush's visit to Israel, Saudi Arabia and Egypt and expressed fears that the peace process had lost credibility and the window of opportunity for peace is closing. The Legal Forum for the Land of Israel on Friday called for a halt to the transfer of arms to the Palestinian Authority in the West Bank. The group's demand came in the wake of Friday's drive-by shooting in which three Israeli hikers were wounded, one seriously, as they toured a wadi near Neve Tzuf in the Binyamin region northwest of Ramallah. The Fatah al-Aqsa brigades claim responsibility for the attack. U.S. presidential candidate Barack Obama said Saturday that Israel is justified in providing for its security amid the extraordinary threat posed to it by Iran. Obama's statements were shortly after the New York Times published an article claiming Israel recently conducted a large-scale air force drill in the Mediterranean that was a rehearsal for an airstrike on Iran's nuclear facilities.
Thank you for watching InfoLive TV, Israel's only internet television network that broadcasts in four languages from Jerusalem to the world.
That's all for InfoLive TV, Israel's only internet television website that broadcasts in four languages to the world.